Hey, how's it going, guys? I hope you're having a great day and had an amazing weekend. There are some settings you need to know about Premiere Pro to improve your performance and your workflow. So I will show you which ones I use and which ones work for me. I'm Jose Daniel and welcome back to another video. If you're not sure what are the requirements for Premiere Pro, check out that link in the top and I'll leave you the link in the description below as well. So let's jump to the Premiere Pro. So if you are in a Mac, you just go here on the top and where it says Premiere Pro, open it and choose Preference and then press Start with General. If you're using a PC, just go to Edit and then in the bottom over here, you will find the Preference settings. So let's go and check Start with General. Here in General, we can see different options. I just leave it as it is. That's a default. The only thing I changed was this one, the double clip when I'm using a bigger monitor. This one will be okay because you can do open in a new window or open in place or a new tab. So I just do open in a new window. And here I can just put on side that bin for the folder. I can check the footage and then at the same time check the timeline. The rest is leave it as it is. And then here in appearance, we can change the brightness, the highlight colors. I just leave it like that. And then here in the audio, I don't touch anything. I just leave it as a default. And here in the audio hardware, here we can check the inputs and the output. So for example, in the MacBook Pro, when I editing in that, so I can hear the playback from the speakers or the headphone if I'm using headphones. But when you choose to work in a monitor, you're using the HDMI, and you didn't want to check and you want to hear the audio from the monitor to the speakers, you don't have connect the laptop, right? So here is where you have to come, and then if you have the monitor, it will appear here and you will just change it from there. Make sure, because sometimes happen to me when I using Audition and Premiere Pro, I have to change the preference and sometimes doesn't give me the playback. So make sure the Audition on the Premiere Pro or any other application you're using, the audio hardware match are the same. If not, could happen that have some issues with that and you won't be able to hear or they say not responding or something like that. So just keep in mind that, and the rest just leave it as it is. Then the ones of the important settings is the auto save. This you can automatically save projects. You can choose automatically save every 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, it's up to you. And then you have maximum versions. You have 20, 10, you can change that option as well. Consider to have enabled. I have it disabled at the moment, but let's enable this. You can save backup projects to Creative Cloud in case you want to have a backup in the Creative Cloud as well as in the hard drive. So this is important because imagine you are working for 2-3 hours. Sometimes when we are really focused in editing and we just, I don't know, doing the color grading, the applying effects, sound design, that kind of stuff, sometimes we just lose, we lose notion of the time. We don't know how much we have been working on. It could be 2-4 hours, and then could happen the Premiere Pro crash and stop working, and you have to reopen the file, and you realize that you didn't save, and then you say, okay, what else how to do? I have to start again, and maybe it won't have the same motivation. You know, sometimes we apply one effect with one vision, and then if we have to redo it again, you won't have the same vision as the first one. So if you save automatically your project every period of time, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, you choose what is the time, that time you want to. And then this will help you and will save from lose any change or anything you have in stuff. Sometimes as well is good because maybe the file crashed and you cannot open it. It's damaged, the file, for example. And then you have some backups before of that file, and then you just can go back and check those files. You have other options to carry on working. So let me know in the comments if it happened to you once a time. I bet you it happens to you once. So let me know in the comments below. So let's move on. And here in the capture, I don't touch anything, it's Asus default. And then the collaboration as well, the control surface, the device control as well. But here in the collaboration, this is, if you are working in the same project with different people are working in the same project, you just set up this one. To be honest, I haven't used this feature, so I'm not 100% sure how it works. But let me know in the comments as well if you want to know how this feature works, because I hear that there are too many options. You can export the file as well in a RAW instead of compressing the file, and you won't lose quality. So let me know in the comments if you want to watch this tutorial. So let's move on. So as I said, in control surface, I just don't touch anything, device control either. Just here in the graphics. Here the graphics basically is the text and the fonts we use for our graphics or titles. For the missing font replacement, this is when you import any graphics that maybe you download from internet. When you are going to use it, they are using a different font that you don't have installed in your computer. This won't find the font, and then you have to tell Premiere Pro which fonts you want to use instead of that missing font. So here you can choose which one is the replacement and which one do you want. Then here in the labels, you can see here the label colors and the label defaults. It would be great if we can add more colors as it is. But here, for example, you can change the color. If you don't like these ones, the default ones, you just click them and then you can change the colors. And then let's say you don't like the label's name and you just want to use this one instead of violet, you just do, let's say this one is the B-rolls, and let's say the green one, the Caribbean, is the main video, and then the forest is the audio, and then the purple effects, visual effects, sound effects, it's up to you. Let's say visual effects, and so on. So you can just modify them, edit as you like it. And then the label default, you can change the colors as well. For the movie, you just come here and choose any of these ones we just labeled on the left. You can choose from there. Here in the media, I use media time base. I use 23 to 96 frames per second. I just leave it like it is. The time code, I leave it like that as well. The frame count as well. But here in default media scaling, you have different options. You have none. You have a scale to frame size and set to frame size. But what is this? Let's say you're using, you're working a project with a HD resolution and you have different footage with different resolution. You have a HD resolution, 4K, 2K, UHD or 6K, for example, but your main sequence is using HD. So what happens when you import the footage into the timeline? The footage, if you have in none here in this case, the 4K footage is going to be higher. It's going to be like really high on the screen. So you can see here how it looks when we import it. So we can see it's really big. And then to change the settings, you have to go to the monitor source here and then go to effects control and then the scale to match the size, right? But here, if we choose this option here, we have different options. So we can choose scale to frame size. If we choose scale to frame size, when we import the same footage to the timeline, this will rasterize the footage and it's going to scale to the frame size. The good thing of this, when you render it, it's going to be faster, but the downside of the scale to frame size, as this one is rasterized the video, it will lose a resolution. So the good practice is going to be the set to frame size. This one, it will apply in the effect control panels, so it's going to scale down and to match the size and will keep the resolution. It's going to take more time to render the footage. To be honest, I would prefer to wait more than lose resolution. So then the other things, I just leave it as it is. Here you can enable the proxies if you're using proxies. So basically proxies is when you have these same files, 4K, 6K, can play really smooth in the timeline and you just glitter the footage and everything. You have some slow down the process. So then you create proxies. If you want to know how it works the proxies, let me know in the comment. I will make a tutorial for that. So let me know if you like to see that tutorial. And the other options, I just leave it like that. Here in growing files, automatically refresh growing files. This basically Premiere Pro, in this case we have 60 seconds. It's going to check all the footage every 60 seconds and it's going to take time, you know, it's going to consume some resources from the memory RAM or the CPU just to looking for the footage or the files. Let's say all the files you have into the project, it's going to refresh every 60 seconds. And then the media cache is an important one. This one, we can check the media cache files, the location. I recommend you to delete this one once in a while. But what the caches mean? This is going to make a quick access to the files you are working on. You are working a project with some files, and basically your storage in the SSD drive or the hard drive, and then the cache is going to store those files in the memory RAM or in the CPU. And then it will have a quick access, or even in the SSD drive, you have a cache as well over there. And then it will have a quick access to those ones. But if you don't delete those ones, and you forget to you finish the project and you still carry on working on other projects, the other new projects is going to need that cache as well, that space. But if you still have the old ones and you stop using them, you won't have space for the new files. So it's good if you delete them, because if you keep them, will slow down the process and you will have some issues with the Premiere Pro, like maybe crashing or maybe working slower. For example, I have one SSD drive for the apps and one SSD drive for the current files I'm working on. So for the apps, I just leave it for apps. Don't store any files over there or anything. For this cache, we can just store in that specific SSD drive or hard drive. If you have or if you can do it, just do it. I recommend it to do it, just store in that specific SSD drive storage. And the other thing, the media cache management, let's say you forget to do this one in a while, sometimes you just working and you forget to delete the files, you can just automatically delete them. So basically you can set up for days. I choose 7 days because for normally I don't take more than 7 days to edit a video to finish the project. It's 7 days for me, it works well. Or you can check the capacity. When that reached that capacity, it will still adding a new files, but the old ones that you don't use anymore, they will delete it and then create a new space for the new files. It will be up to you which one of those options you like more. So I have for the days because it will delete all the footage that I am using anymore. And then for the memory, this one here, allow the memory as much as you can for Premiere Pro, After Effects, all the footage. So basically here we have only RAM reserved for other applications, 3 GB. I cannot go lower than that. But the rest, I have 13 GB for those applications. So if you have a higher capacity memory RAMs in your PC or in your computer, you will be able to dedicate that RAM for these applications. And then here in optimize rendering for, I have a memory and we have performance. This one is will help you to render faster. I recommend to use performance, just check it out, that one there. So let's move back to playback. This one just as default, the same with the sync settings and the timeline and the trim, I leave it like that. I hope this video helped you to understand the preference settings for Premiere Pro. So that's it for today, guys. Hit the like button, leave your comment below. Maybe I will make a tutorial for export settings. Let me know in the comments below. Click here to subscribe and here to watch more videos, and see you guys in the next video.